Okay, Isrin. So basically, we are going to start from the chapter electricity. Yesterday, we have also discussed some important things regarding this chapter. But before starting the chapter, look at here. What is it? This is your marks distribution for final exams. Okay, this is your marks distribution for final exams. Total forms will be 5. Okay. I have explained this whole thing in the previous lecture. If you want to go in further detail, so please listen to the previous lecture that I have uploaded yesterday on Google Classroom. Okay. Just now, what I'm going to tell you that your science final paper will be comprises of 5 forms. Form number 1 will be of 40 marks and it will carry MCQs. Okay. Form number 2 will be of 10 marks and it will carry some important reasons. Right, you have to pick the right reason here. Then in form number 3, that will carry 20 marks, and here this is basically question answer section. How I'm going to ask the question answer, just I'm going to ask the definitions or important terminologies. Just suppose what is atomic number, state, what is electroplating, electromagnetism. So what I'm going to give you, I'm going to give you some important options regarding the definition, and you have to pick which is the correct definition. Then form number 4, which is of again 20 marks, but it is true false. And the last one is form number 5, which is of 10 marks, and it is diagram section. Okay, now today I'm going to explain you how we are going to conduct this section. As you know, MCQs, you have already attempted so many MCQs in your monthly test and class test. Obviously, you have attempted reasons, question answer, true false, but I think this is a new thing for you, that how we are going to ask diagrams in the final exam. So I'm going to explain this topic today. Okay, and I'm going to explain all the important diagrams regarding the chapter electricity. Okay, today we are only focusing on chapter electricity, and obviously we are going to mark some important MCQs as well. I hope all of you are ready. So all of you, please keep books in front of you. You must have your books. Everyone, please open books, page number 193, and the chapter is electricity. Are you ready? Please tell me. This lecture is important, so please listen to me very carefully. Why other students are not replying? Only Shahrooz and Halima is replying. Okay, Rida. Yes, I'm going to explain, Anamta, that how this section will be conducted. Okay, diagram section, how we are going to conduct the diagram section. Okay, now, if you look, listen, if you have listened the previous lecture, so I have marked this important definitions here, right? So please listen the previous lecture. Now I'm going to explain this thing again. Look at her here. This is conventional current. Okay, what is a conventional current? Actually, I have explained in previous clause that according to the previous concept, what was the previous concept? That current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. This was your old concept. Okay, this was your old concept, that current always flows from positive to negative terminal. But later it was discovered that actually it is the electrons. Okay, actually electrons are the particles that move. Okay, that move throughout the circuit, and then it will produce a current, and obviously it will move towards the positive side. Okay, previously what people think, that actually movement of positive charge result in the production of current, but that was an old concept. According to new concept, and this is the correct concept, that electrons that carries negative charge, they move throughout the circuit to produce current, and obviously they will move towards the positive charge. Okay, but people are habitual of this concept. Okay, though they are habitual of this concept, so still we always say that current flows or current produced when charges move from positive to negative terminal. So this old concept is basically called as conventional current. Okay, this is the conventional current, but the actual concept is this one. Okay, so here you have a picture of flow of conventional current. Okay, flow of conventional current and flow of electric charges. Now, look at here, according to this figure, what is happening here? This is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal of the battery. Just a minute. Okay. This is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal of the battery. And this figure represents conventional current. Why? Because according to arrow, this is the arrow that is moving towards the left side, and then current is flowing towards this side and it will moving towards the negative side. Means from positive to negative. So this is an old concept and this is called conventional current. But the new concept, which is actually the flow of electric charges, they start from the negative terminal of the battery. That is the flow of electrons. Why electrons? Because electrons carry negative charge. And electrons move towards the positive end and then current will produce. Okay. So now question is how we are going to ask this diagram in your paper. Now listen, how we are going to ask, we simply ask you just suppose question is flow of conventional current, show with the help of diagram flow of conventional current. So obviously you are not going to draw that diagram. What I'm going to give you, I'm going to give you both the diagrams. Okay, I'm going to give you both the circuits. These are basically circuit diagram. Okay, I'm going to give you both the circuits and you have to identify which is conventional current and which is electric charges. My question is identify the conventional current. Okay, my question is identify the conventional current. So how you will identify where arrows moving from positive to negative end. So this is conventional current, both figures will be there and you have to pick the correct figure. So dono figures aapke paas maujood hongi, aapko just click karna hai, just pick karna hai ki kaun si correct figure hai. Now please tell me, is this portion clear? Is it clear? Is it clear? समझ आया कि किस तरह से हम आपसे पूछेंगे? Move on to the next topic. Right? Okay. Now, next is some important definitions like that can be asked in MCQs or in true false section or in question answer section is, just suppose electric current is defined as the rate of flow of electric charges. Okay, how electric current you will define? The rate, at what rate electric charges are moving throughout the circuit, their rate is called as electric current. Okay, the SI unit for electric current is ampere. All of you know that. Please mark it. Everyone, please mark this. Books open कीजिए और इसको mark कीजिए. Everyone. Turn on your camera so that. Okay. Now another important point is electric currents are measured by instruments called ammeters. Okay. How we will measure electric current by the instrument called ammeter. Okay, is it clear? Now look at here, this one. Ammeters must be connected in series. You should know how we will connect ammeters in circuit in a series. Okay, one after another with a single loop. All the things will be connected with a single wire. Now, how we are going to ask this thing? We're going to ask which is the correct way to connect ammeter in a circuit. Okay, the question will be which is the correct way to connect ammeter. This is ammeter. To connect ammeter in a circuit means ammeter ko aap kis tarah se circuit mein connect kar sakte. Then what we will give you these three diagrams as an options. Okay, these three diagrams we are going to give you in the options and you have to pick which one is the correct. As you can see, this is the correct. Why it is the correct? Because they are connecting with a single wire in a series circuit, and ammeter must be, it is important, it is all always connected in series. If you are going to connect it in parallel line, just suppose यहाँ पर ये parallelly connected है, तो भी ये wrong circuit है. यहाँ पर ये after the battery connected है or before the electrical component, so this is also a wrong one. Okay, so this is the correct way to connect the ammeter in a circuit, and you have to pick only the correct connection. That's it. Okay, no need to draw the diagram, just you have to identify which is the correct way to connect it in a circuit, right? Is it clear? Now next topic is this one, which is electric circuits. Now look at here, what are electric circuit? Okay, what are electric circuits? An electric circuit is the path. Okay, it is the path. Path means it is the pathway, road, along which electric charges move. Okay, obviously where electric charges will move. So what is an electric circuit? The path on which electric charges move. Just suppose, what is the path? Basically, it consists of source of electrical energy, that is your battery. Okay, what is your source of electrical energy? That is your battery. Connecting wires, these are the wires. Okay, these are the wires. And one or more electrical components such as switches, meters or bulb. Koi bhi electrical component ho, aapke paas bulb, tube light, whatever. Okay, so this is the simplest electric circuit, which comprises of a battery, connecting wires, and this is the bulb. Okay, an electric circuit is a path along which electric charges, when the current will be produced here, so electrons start moving throughout this pathway. So, okay, so this is basically called what? This is basically called electric circuits. Okay, now electric circuits can be broadly divided into two main types, series circuit and parallel circuit. It is divided into two main types. Number one is series circuit and parallel circuit. In series circuit, what will happen? Basically, each component is connected with a single loop of wire. Okay, they are connected with a single loop of wire, one after another, one after another. So this is called a series circuit, which in which it will form only a single loop, and components are connected one after another with a single loop. That loop is single wire, that wire is connected with the battery. This is basically called a series circuit. Okay, now this thing in which you have a definition, okay, this thing can be asked in your MCQ section, so mark it. Okay, this thing can be asked in the MCQ section, and we are going to ask you which is the correct representation of series circuit. Ab aapke paas different hongi, jaise ki ye series circuit hai, ye bhi ek circuit hai, to aapne isme se you have to identify which one is the series circuit. Okay, you have to identify which one is the series circuit. Now I'm going to explain parallel circuit as well. Now look at here, what is parallel circuit? A parallel circuit, okay, mark it in your book. A parallel circuit is one that splits into two or more branches with connected electrical components. Okay, now what will happen? It will break into two or more branches. How many branches are there? Branch number 1, 2, and 3. Basically, each electrical component is connected with a separate wire, with the battery. Okay, they are connecting with the separate wires in the battery, and they are basically forming three loops. This is loop number 1, this is loop number 2, and this is loop number 3. So such type of circuits are called as parallel circuit. Okay, now what is the advantage of parallel circuit and what is the disadvantage of series circuit? Basically, if there is a break in a wire, kahin se bhi break hota, yahan se break ho jaye, it will be break from this side. Whenever it will break, there is a single break in, whenever at which side, current will stop flowing throughout the circuit. Okay, current will stop flowing throughout the circuit and the bulb will not glow. Okay, but in a parallel circuit, what is the advantage? If a break occur in a single loop, just suppose yahan pe break aa jata hai, so others function will not stop. Okay, only the function of this bulb will be stopped, but others bulb function will not stop. Other will continue their working. Okay, so this is the advantage of parallel circuit. Again, the question is how we are going to ask this diagrams. Simply, we will ask you which is the series circuit. So you have to identify which one is the series circuit in which there is a single loop. If you have multiple loops, so that will be a parallel circuit. Clear? Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay. Now, next is we can also ask this thing, that bridges connected in parallel. Okay, so we can ask you that which is this, what is happening here. Okay, we can ask you, we look at this figure and the question is bridges connected in parallel or in series. So what is happening here, bridges is connected in parallel or in series? Kis mein connected hai? They are connected in parallel. So you have to opt the right option. Correct option is parallel. So you will say that this basically shows that bridges are connected in parallel. Okay, if there is a break or if there is a damage to one bridge, other function will not be stopped. Understand? Now, this is the light. Oh, sorry. This is the reason that can be asked in the reason section. Are the lights in your classroom connected in series or in parallel? So please, everyone, please tell me, look at this lights and please tell me these are connected in series or in parallel. Everyone, please reply. Which connection is this, series circuit or parallel circuit? Why it is parallel? Because why? If there is a break in or if there is any... Yes, parallel. Okay, if there is a break or if there is any damage to one wire or one bulb, the function of other electrical components will not stop. Okay, so that's why lights in the classroom are always connected in parallel. Right? Is it clear? Yes, this is a parallel circuit. Now, move on to this one. Very important. This is always very important. What we will ask you, this is basically electrical components and their symbols. Obviously, if you are going to draw an electrical circuit, so we are not, every time we cannot draw a proper bulb, a proper switch, a proper resistors. So for that, we are using specific symbols. Okay, obviously, if you are going to make a switch, just suppose here, as you can see, this is the switch. So every time it is not possible for us to draw this switch. So instead of this, what we will use this electrical component, the symbol of this electrical component. Just suppose the symbol of switch open is this one. Okay, switch yahan par open hai. Switch close hai, to connected hai. Okay, this is electrical cell. Electrical cell means positive and negative end. Positive end is greater. Sirf thoda sa usko bada karke dikhaya gaya hai. Negative end thoda sa chota hai. Okay, so this is very important. Agar aapko paas electrical cell maujood ho aur wo aise ho. Ye ho, theek hai? This is negative. This is positive. Aur isko likh diya jaye ki ye negative hai. So this is completely wrong. Okay, this is the wrong one. So correct way is this is positive, this is negative. This is the symbol of battery. These are the symbols of wires joined at a junction ki jahan par join hue hain, cross kar rahe wire ek dusre ko. So basically these are some important symbols and you have to prepare it. We can ask you which is the correct way or which is the correct symbol of the given electrical components. We can ask you this thing as well. This is a symbol for bulb. Okay, this is a symbol for resistor, variable resistor, fuse. This is a symbol for fuse, power supply. Okay, so these are the symbols. Important one is this plug key, millivolt meter, volt meter, ammeter, milliammeter, ammeter. So these are very important symbols. Okay, is it clear? Okay, now if you talk about the definition, so here you have the definition of voltage. Now look at here. What is the definition of voltage? The amount of energy supplied by the source of electrical energy to each unit of electric charge is called the voltage. the amount of energy supplied. That amount of energy, बेटा प्लग की जो आपके पास प्लग होता है ना, जो प्लग से हम कनेक्ट करते हैं, जो आपका प्लग होता है, वो जो वायर होता है जिसको हम कनेक्ट करते हैं, वो आपके पास प्लग है ना, जिसे कनेक्ट करके आपके पास करंट फ्लो करेगा, वो है प्लग. ओके, नाउ द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी सप्लाइड बाय द सोर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. व्हाट इज द सोर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी? ऑब्वियसली बैटरी. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंड, this is just suppose battery, this is positive end and this is negative end. So what this battery will give, it will give energy. Okay, this energy will be used by electrons to move around the circuit. So the amount of energy that is produced, the amount of energy that is supplied to each unit of electric charge is called the voltage. So that amount of energy is basically called as voltage. Okay, so this is the definition of voltage. Some important definitions, just suppose here, this science tidbit is very important. This is very important. I have explained it in the revision lecture. What you have here, the voltage of a source of electrical energy is called its electromotive forces. What? Basically, इसी voltage को that जो कि इसमें energy provide हो रही होती, इसको हम और क्या कहते हैं? It is also called as electromotive force. Okay, similarly the voltage between any two points in a circuit is called the potential difference. Just suppose this is a circuit, voltage at this point and is that point obviously different. Okay, so the difference in these two voltage is called as the potential difference. Okay, now next important thing is the SI unit for voltage is the volt. The SI unit for voltage is the volt. Also a voltmeter is the instrument that is used for measuring voltmeter. Another important thing, clear? Is it clear? I'm going to start the next topic, so please tell me, is it clear? Only one student is replying. What's now look at here again, we can ask, as you know, that ammeter, voltmeter must be connected in parallel. Okay, it must be connected in parallel in the circuit. So again, we can ask, which is the correct way, which is a correct way, oh yes, which is way, correct way to connect voltmeter in a circuit. Okay, correct way, tino maujood hongi. So this one is correct. Why this one is correct? Because voltmeter always connected in parallel. It is always connected in parallel. Okay, so this is the correct way, right? Now student, please tell me, is it clear? Okay, now look at here, the next thing is this one, which is very important, effects of electric current. Effects of electric current. Okay, now look at here, what we are going to ask you, what type of different effects of electric current, heating effect, magnetic effect, whatever. Okay, now look at here. Now look at here. What you have here, what, how can we ask? Just suppose here you have a different one, rice cooker, hair dryer, light bulb, electric toaster, iron. So these are the, basically these are the electrical appliances that uses the heating effect of a current. As you know, rice cooker uses a heating effect, hair dryer, light bulb, electric toaster and iron. So we can ask that which effect of current is has been used by these electrical appliances. Option will be heating effect, magnetic effect, या केमिकल इफेक्ट. सो विच इफेक्ट दे आर यूजिंग, दे आर यूजिंग बेसिकली हीटिंग इफेक्ट. सो यू शुड नो अबाउट ईच इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंसेज दैट विच effect of electric current they are using. There are three effects of electric effect, electric current: heating effect, magnetic effect, and chemical effect. Okay, so you have to pick which effect has been are using in this electrical appliances. Okay, now another very important thing is this one. Now this figure, now what is it? This is basically an electric kettle. Okay, this is an electric kettle. This electric kettle also uses what? It is also uses heating effect. Okay, heating effect of the electric current. But for heating effect, which element will be used here? Which element? So you should know that the heating element is usually made up of nichrome wire, because it has a high resistance and high melting point. Resistance and melting points. Two things. Why we are using nichrome wire? High resistance means higher the resistance, higher amount of heat will be produced. किसी भी element की जितनी ज़्यादा high resistance होगी उतना ज़्यादा वो heat produce करेगा. Obviously, whenever heat is produced, so what is the effect of heat? It will always melt down the things. If the proper the particular element has low melting point. अगर उसका मेल्टिंग पॉइंट लो हो और रेजिस्टेंस आप उसकी बढ़ा दें, मीन्स उसका हीटिंग इफेक्ट इंक्रीज कर दें, सो इट विल स्टार्ट मेल्टिंग. सो यू शुड हैव यूज अ प्रॉपर एलिमेंट दैट मस्ट हैव अ हाई रेजिस्टेंस एज वेल हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, मीन्स अपॉन रीचिंग अ हाईएस्ट टेम्परेचर, बहुत ज़्यादा हीटअप होने के बाद भी इट विल नॉट स्टार्ट मेल्टिंग. ओके, सो इन दिस वन विच इज़ एन इलेक्ट्रिकल कैटल, वट विल हैपन? वी विल यूज निक्रोम वायर. Okay, nichrome wire for high resistance. We are using nichrome wire as an heating element, and also we are using copper wires that have low resistance. Obviously, हमें इस wire में heat produce नहीं करनी. Okay, we are not going to produce heat in this wire. So we will use copper wire here. Why? Because it has low resistance. But here we required heat. For this, we will use those wires that have high resistance. Why high resistance? Higher the resistance, greater amount of heat will be released. So nichrome wire will be used as an heating element here, right? So we can ask you here, which heating element can be used in electrical kettle? Yes. Okay. Then this is the figure. Again, bulb. Okay, here we can ask which is the heating element in this one. So as you know that the heating element in this one is tungsten filament. Okay, it may get so hot that it start glowing, giving out white light. Okay, so here the heating element is basically tungsten wire. Okay, tungsten filament in the bulb, right? So we can ask you in this figure, which is the heating element? So here the heating element is tungsten. Here the heating element is nichrome, right? Now look at here, electric chemical effect of a current. Now here you have a chemical effect of a current. So in chemical effect of a current, the most important example of is this one is electrolysis. This is very important. Please mark it. We can ask it in the question answer session. Okay, define electrolysis and you have to pick the correct definition. So electrolysis is the chemical decomposition. Decomposition means breakdown. Decompose means to break something. Decomposition of an electrolyte by an electric current. जो भी आपका electrolyte होगा, just suppose electrolyte is sodium chloride solution. So if you want to break it into its component that are sodium and chlorine, that is their respective charges, positive and negative charges, but by using electric current, so this is called as electrolysis. Lysis means to break something, electro means electricity, means break down something with the help of electricity. So this is called as electrolysis. Now the most important thing is this one. Electrolysis also used in electroplating. In electroplating, what we will did, we will plate the material. We will coat the objects with a thin layer of metal. Just suppose, as you can see here, chromium plated car bumper, गोल्ड प्लेटेड आइटम्स. तो ये गोल्ड प्लेटेड आइटम्स कैसे बनते हैं, इसमें हम क्या करते हैं, कोटिंग करते हैं. व्हाट वी विल डू द कोटिंग ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट्स. ओके, नाउ दिस इज बेसिकली रिप्रेजेंट द कॉपर प्लेटिंग ऑफ आयरन नेल, और सिंपली यू कैन से दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रो प्लेटिंग. दिस रिप्रेजेंट इलेक्ट्रो प्लेटिंग. Okay, and obviously what are you using here? Process of electrolysis is using here. Okay, here which process is using? Electrolysis. Now what will happen here? Here you have a cell. On the cell you have positive terminal and negative terminal. Both these terminals are connected with this one. Now what is you have? This is the copper coin. Okay, copper coin is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, and the material that is to be coated, that is the iron nail. This is the iron nail, and you have to coat it with the copper one. So it is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. When the current start flowing, so what will happen? It will start releasing this from copper. Copper yahan se released hona shuru ho jayega. It will come into solution, and then it will start coating on this iron nail. So basically, this electroplating has been carried out by the process of electro. Electrolysis. Which process are you using in electroplating? Electrolysis is the process, right? So this figure is basically showing electroplating in which electrolysis is used. And in electroplating, what you will do? Coating of the object. Here, what you are coating? Here you are coating iron nail. Why which metal? Iron metal, copper metal. Okay. So this is a copper plating of iron nail, right? Is it clear? Now what is this one? What is this one? Is this electroplating? Is this electroplating? So what is it? If this is not electroplating, then what is it is? So you should know the difference between electroplating and electromagnetism. In electroplating, you must have an electrolytes. बैटरी मस्ट बी देयर. इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स होना चाहिए. वॉट इज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स? कोई भी सॉल्यूशन दैट कैरीज पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज. ओके, बट दिस इज नॉट इलेक्ट्रोप्लेक्टिंग. दिस इज बेसिकली द प्रोसेस. दिस फिगर बेसिकली रिप्रेजेंट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिज्म, इन विच वॉट यू विल डू, यू विल मेक अ मटीरियल दैट इज नॉट अ मैग्नेट बाय फ्लोइंग बाय द हेल्प ऑफ करंट. Right. Okay. Time is running out. I'm going to end the lecture here, and we are going to start from this point in the next class. Okay. So, students, if you want to ask anything, if you have any question, you can ask right now. And I would like to say thank you to all of you. Do you have any question? Yeah. Okay, how is the lecture? Is it helpful?